Girl, you deserve every pose. Sometimes, yeah, I do the most. I want everybody to know. So, yeah. I am so sorry for being so into you. My family ask about you all the time, but we don't do interviews, no. You take a pic, I might just say the shit. They be my favorite, no. I do not stalk your page and shit, no. I got my ways and shit. 9 times out of 10, you look better than your friend, yo. You're a 10 out of 10, I'ma have to pick on my chin, yeah. Got me like, ooh, yeah, yeah. Screaming that shit, yeah, yeah. That my bitch, god damn, she so thick. Got me like, ooh, yeah, yeah. That my bitch, just one more pick, yeah. Man, I'm buzzing this.
She so good. She looks so good. She looks so good. She so good. So this is all chalkboard paint, and then we primed these two walls. Obviously this wall before we put the chalkboard paint on. We also primed this wall. All we have left is to prime up there. This wall, that is primed. We just haven't had time to like move the desk and everything.
Takes now, baby girl, you stay down. Tight dress, I can see them curves busting every week. Girl, you got the love.
She's got me in the dark.
Like, ooh, screaming that shit. That my bitch, god damn, she so thick. Got me like, ooh,
yeah, oh my god.
Yeah, that my bitch,
oh my god.
Just one more pick,
you
bet I'm buzzing this.
She's so good. She looks so good. She looks so good. She's so good. She looks so good. She looks so good.
Bet I'm buzzing this.
Okay, hey y'all, I feel like wide angle isn't the best quality, but I feel like it's the only way I can really show you guys the whole room. So I am almost done painting. This wall, and up to here and up there has 2 coats on it. And then this wall I just did today and it has 1 coat. I will do the 2nd coat maybe later today or tomorrow. But then it should be done. I don't think it'll need a 3rd coat. It's drying really nice. It was really splotchy this morning, so that's why I did a 2nd coat. Everything is just literally all over the place because the walls are drying. I'm so excited. I love how it's coming together. I did it all by myself, so I'm just really proud of myself. And honestly, it's super rewarding, and I cannot wait to get the new furniture for this place, specifically this room and my bedroom. And yeah, everything is coming together, falling into place, and everything will be okay and work out how it's supposed to work out. I keep reminding myself that, but I'm so proud of myself. This is the first time I've ever painted like interior walls as well. I mean, I've never even painted a house before, so I am pretty proud of myself. This also lifts up so I can paint and draw with an elevated surface. But it looks so good. Thanks, babe. Here's the art room with my wide camera. I kind of just want to show the whole thing the best that I can, but I will go into more detail in the next clip. Here's my art room when you first walk in. It's messy. This is just the reality. It will never be fully clean. I'm always in here working on stuff. But basically, right by the door, we have this little shelving unit.
This first drawer has notepads, calculator, Tic Tacs, extra erasers, just random stuff. The second drawer is glue, Mod Podges, and all my sealers for my paint. And then the bottom drawer is most of my acrylic paint.
And then I have my little corkboard. I have some painting tips. A couple things here people made for me. Or like, this is my Uncle Joe's when he was little. Got my printers over here. I just have printer paper under there. These are canvases that I haven't used. And then like stuff that I want to use in my projects. I also have this little storage unit here with more stuff.
And then in this storage unit, the top drawer is scrapbooks and blunt wraps that I use for my art. The second drawer is stuff for my dream catchers, some more beads. And the bottom drawer has just more coloring supplies.
My lovely gallery wall. I'm so obsessed with her. This is actually a chalkboard wall. I had to take pictures of that to sell. I need to re-tie-dye that. This is my old artwork that I just don't know what to do with. I have more crystals here. So beautiful. And then I have this storage unit, and I was actually gifted these, and I spray painted them black. I got them like a white, off-white color. Here I have sketchbooks, watercolor paper, and a cute pumpkin. I have more paper, some more books, some scrapbook stuff, this cool little like sketch pad thing. That's a mini coloring book, my tie-dye stuff, my packaging for my clothes and my jewelry stuff, more jewelry stuff, my lovely bamboo plant that I need to repot. And then here's my desk, and I have my wood burning stuff out because I was working on stuff. And this little storage unit has mainly crystal stuff in it. And then I have just some paintbrushes up here, markers, pencils, pens, just like essential stuff I need. This is my notebook for my children's books that I'm working on, and I do have like this to-do list thing that I keep on there. So here I just have like extra paints. I have my oil pastels. These are oil paints. These are acrylic paints. And then I have these very fancy ink paints, which I need to actually do something with. Watercolors. And a ton of extra paper, notebook, sketch paper, line paper, all that good stuff. And then under here, I have just like a washcloth or a towel that I use, a travel thing for my paintbrushes. I use these for when I do like my scrape paints. What do you call these, palettes? This is a Japanese, I believe, ink kit. It's actually really cool. I need to do something with it. All my coloring books and some more art books there. Also have a closet here, which I do utilize for clothes and other art stuff. And I love this wall over here. I got like all these same when I went inpatient. And then directly from the closet, right by my desk, are my shelves. And I'm so happy it took me a while to decorate. But I have this little man figure, a crystal, a Starry Night mug, which I actually broke, so I had to hot glue it back. This Day of the Dead mask, which also broke, and I had to re-glue it. This amethyst tree my boyfriend got me. I made this painting, this cute little gnome ornament artist that my Nana got me, a bowl with some more rocks in it, another crystal, this cute little fairy garden that I painted at a pottery place, and this cute little flower shoe that I found while cleaning. I really, really love how it all turned out. It looks so good. This was a series I had to do besides that one. This was like a series of natural landscapes I had to do for art class. My other gallery wall that I love so much. Yes, everything you see here I have created. All of these paintings here I made in high school, which is pretty cool. Those were also in high school. These were high school, and recently, all my art over here was pretty recent. That was in high school, but I really love it. I also have my sketchbook up here with this little snake flower head that I made in high school as well. I made that incense holder too. But yeah, I love this. This means love. My dad's favorite piece I made. I also have my art smock. And yeah, that is my full art room. This took literally over a year to complete, and I did most of it by myself with the help of some friends and my boyfriend, and I love it. It's my safe place. Purple is my favorite color, if you can't tell. I love it. I'm just so proud of myself. Like I said, it took over a year to complete, probably longer. So the biggest thing was obviously purchasing the furniture and all of that stuff. And a lot of the stuff in here though, I have reused from, it was either in my bathroom or it was in my dad's room or my sister gave it to me. So I'm very grateful, but I did buy a new desk and a new chair and all that. Had to buy a printer and everything. But yeah, I love my art room. I hope you guys enjoy. Comment down below what you think of it. What's your favorite part of my art room? My favorite part is probably this wall, or the wall with all the really nice sayings of like self-acceptance and beauty and mindfulness and world peace and stuff like that. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.